As of January 11th of 2026, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the same number as were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Hawaii's Kilauea Shield volcano, which began its precursory lava fusion on January 9th. Kilauea has been experiencing a fairly predictable episodic cycle for just over a year, ending in hours-long sustained periods of lava fountaining. The U.S. Geological Survey currently predicts that the 40th such episode of lava fountaining will begin sometime between January 10th, before this video goes live, and January 14th. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Italy, an earthquake swarm struck Mount Vesuvius, producing in a single day the same number of small magnitude earthquakes the volcano would normally produce in a month. Meanwhile, in Vanuatu, the scenic Ambrym volcano potentially may have begun a weak new eruption, which has the potential to further escalate. And, in what is this week's top story, the highly symmetrical Mayon volcano had its effusive and explosive eruption escalate, resulting in the evacuation of 3,000 nearby residents who lived within its 6-kilometer exclusion zone. This gorgeous clip of the ongoing eruption taken on the night of January 9th might at first appear to be part of multiple growing lava flows. However, the truth is far more hazardous. While yes, these tumbling incandescent fragments are indeed mostly lava, they merely represent the visible minority of multiple ongoing pyroclastic flows. In other words, during the daytime, this same scene would look like this, clearly displaying the scorching hot pyroclastic flows that I personally measured traveling at speeds of between 30 and 40 miles per hour, or 48 to 64 kilometers per hour. I geolocated several of these pyroclastic flows, of which more than 250 have occurred since January 6th, with the furthest one so far reaching 2,500 meters away from Mayon's summit. While Mayon had been weakly extruding lava since December 8th, lava fusion became not only more substantial but also more gas-rich on January 6th. This is why Mayon's alert level was raised twice in a 6-day time span. These pyroclastic flows are generated in a similar manner to most of Merapi's pyroclastic flows in Indonesia, partial dome collapse. Mayon's summit is rather steep, so when viscous lava is added to its summit lava dome, shown here, parts of it due to the new added material can become unstable and intermittently break off. This allows superheated gas to escape, which then, due to being heavier than surrounding air, collapses back to the ground as pyroclastic flows. While Mayon's eruptive activity could technically further escalate, it for now appears to be fairly stable. Earlier in the week, I had noted a concerning potential for a tropical depression or tropical storm to form and dump heavy rain on the volcano. The good news is that such a strong storm system is now highly unlikely to form. Mayon's ongoing eruption could continue for multiple more weeks or even months. Meanwhile, in Italy, just after 12:10 a.m. on January 5th, a swarm of earthquakes began striking one after the other beneath the infamous Mount Vesuvius. During the next 12 hours, more than 75 such earthquakes struck in essentially the same location as prior earthquake swarms. However, none of these earthquakes were any greater than a magnitude 1.6, meaning that if you were to be standing right above their epicenter during the swarm, you wouldn't have felt any ground motion even if you tried. These earthquakes, which declined thereafter, were most likely caused by the normal underground movement of hydrothermal fluids and gas. In other words, typical activity not of any concern whatsoever for this famous stratovolcano. And in Vanuatu, the Ambrym volcano appears to have initiated a weak eruption, and there is the potential that this eruption could escalate. The local geohazards agency noted increased volcanic tremor and seismicity beginning around 7 a.m. local time on January 7th. What then appeared to be a series of intermittent weak low-level ash emissions occurred, but whether this truly was new ash or just remobilized ash from prior eruptions was uncertain. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on January 10th of 2026. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member, JacquelineCherry9914, for supporting my work.